दोस्तों कैसे हैं आप लोग। चलिए माइक्रोवेव्स मैंने आपको पढ़ाया था तो चलिए इसके कुछ एमसीक्यूज करते हैं, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट हैं। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन है, ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ सिग्नल्स इन अ टेरेस्ट्रियल माइक्रोवेव सिस्टम इज अचीव्ड थ्रू टेरेस्ट्रियल, इट मींस लैंड टू लैंड कम्युनिकेशन। टेरेस्ट्रियल मींस लैंड टू लैंड कम्युनिकेशन। ओके सो हाउ डू द सिग्नल्स ट्रांसमिट इन अ टेरेस्ट्रियल माइक्रोवेव सिस्टम? इज इट अचीव्ड थ्रू रिफ्लेक्शन फ्रॉम आयनोस्फेयर, लाइन ऑफ साइट मोड, रिफ्लेक्शन फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड और डिफ्रेक्शन फ्रॉम द स्ट्रेटोस्फेयर? सी, यू ऑलवेज शुड रिमेंबर दैट द टेरेस्ट्रियल माइक्रोवेव सिस्टम विच इज ए लैंड वेव लैंड टू लैंड कम्युनिकेशन इन विच बोथ द ट्रांसमिटर एंटेनाज एंड द रिसीवर एंटेनाज कैन सी द फेस ऑफ ईच अदर। ओके, द सिग्नल शुड ट्रांसमिट विदाउट एनी ऑब्स्टिकल्स इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन। सो इट इज बेसिकली अचीव थ्रू द लाइन ऑफ साइट मोड। सो मेनली दिस टेरेस्ट्रियल माइक्रोवेव कम्युनिकेशन इज ऑलवेज लाइन ऑफ साइट कम्युनिकेशन। नाउ यू शुड बी नोइंग दैट वॉट इज डिफ्रेक्शन। डिफ्रेक्शन मीन्स वेयर द रेडियो वेव सिग्नल्स गेट डिफ्रेक्टेड, दे गेट बेंड थ्रू द ओपनिंग और सम शार्प एजेस और अराउंड सम ओपनिंग ऑफ एन ऑब्स्टिकल। ओके, इन ऑर्डर टू अचीव द हायर डिस्टेंस रेडियो ब्रॉडकास्टिंग। सो दिस इज बेसिकली डिफ्रेक्शन। एंड वॉट इज स्ट्रेटोस्फेयर? स्ट्रेटोस्फेयर मीन्स इट इज द ओजोन लेयर। बेसिकली इट इज द ओजोन लेयर, इट्स हाइट इज नियरली अबाउट 10 to 50 किलोमीटर्स अबव द अर्थ सर्फेस। ठीक है, सो ये दिस यू शुड बी नोइंग। एंड आयनोस्फेयर, यू नो इट इज द अपर रीजन ऑफ द अर्थ एटमोसफेयर हुज हाइट इज अराउंड यू कैन से 80 to 1000 किलोमीटर्स अपार्ट। 80 टू 1000 किलोमीटर्स अबव द अर्थ सर्फेस। ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, डाइवर्सिटी रिसेप्शन इज, नाउ वॉट इज डाइवर्सिटी? दिस इज मेनली यू टर्म यू माइट बी फेमिलियर इन योर वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन। द डाइवर्सिटी रिसेप्शन मीन्स अ सिग्नल विच इज ट्रांसमिटेड एट अ पर्टिकुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, देर इज अ सिग्नल विच इज ट्रांसमिटेड एट अ पर्टिकुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी एंड एट अ पर्टिकुलर इंस्टेंट ऑफ टाइम। It may be received in a multipath direction. It may be received in a multipath null. So diversity reception, what does it do? That it basically reduces the probability of occurrence of communication failures. It basically reduces the probability of occurrence of communication failures, which is mainly known as outages, okay, caused by fades by combining several copies of same message signal, by combining several copies of same message signal, same empty means message signal received over different channels. So first of all, you should be knowing what is diversity reception. Reception means the ability to receive the signal, and diversity means it reduces the probability of the occurrence of the failures of communication that might be caused by some fluctuation in the signal strength by combining so many copies of the same message signal that has to be received over different channels. Different channels means at different frequencies. Whenever there is a signal, it is to be transmitted at a particular carrier frequency and a particular instant of time. So it may be received in multipath routes. It is not possible that every signal should follow the same path. It may be reaching to the destination by covering so many routes, and through that routes it may go through so many obstacles. They may cause some failure of the signal reception. So there we use diversity reception. Okay, mainly it is a method of improving the faithfulness of the message signal, how much the message signal is secure at the receiver side. So it plays an important role in correcting the faded signal. So answer will be increasing receiver sensitivity, improve receiver selectivity, no. Overcome the degrading effect of fading, yes, because it improves the faded signal. It improves in correcting the faded signal. So this is the C option. ओवरकम डिग्रेडिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ रिसीवर डी ट्यूनिंग? नो, डाइवर्सिटी रिसेप्शन इज मेनली यूज टू ओवरकम द डिग्रेडिंग इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द फेडिंग. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज थर्ड वन. लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस रेडियो कम्युनिकेशन इज पॉसिबल ड्यू टू रिफ्लेक्शन और रिफ्रैक्शन फ्रॉम द एनोस्फेरिक लेयर्स? बिकॉज द रीजन इज बिकॉज refractive indices of different ionized layers cause DIR, total internal reflection of electromagnetic waves. See, this is the assertion reason type question. So in this question, yes, long distance radio communication, it is absolutely true statement that it is possible due to reflection and refraction from the ionospheric layers, because ionosphere mainly it is that layer of the earth's surface, earth atmosphere, which lies at around 80 to 1000 kilometers above the earth's surface, okay, above the earth's surface, and which is responsible for sending the radio waves back towards the earth's surface. If it is earth's surface, so here it just reflects back the radio wave signals back to the earth's surface. So yeah, this is absolutely true statement, and because the reason is that the refractive indices of different ionized layers that I have already told you, DEF1F2, the different ionized layers, their refractive indices cause total internal reflection of electromagnetic wave. Now what is this total internal reflection? You have already studied that it is the complete reflection of the signal. Complete reflection of the light or the radio wave signal through a more dense medium to a less denser medium. It makes the radio wave signal completely reflected from more dense medium to lower dense medium. And for that condition, your angle of incidence should be greater than the critical angle, and angle of refraction should reach 90 degree before the angle of incidence reaches 90 degree. This should be the condition. So this is absolutely right statement. So assertion is, so both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of A. Okay, next question is fourth question. Now here, which of the following pairs of the types of wave propagation and associated property are correctly matched? See, surface wave, is it related to vertical polarization? Okay, and then it is duct propagation related to super refraction, or sky wave, it is related to critical frequency. So the answer will be D option. Duct propagation is related to super refraction and sky wave is related to critical frequency. Now let me tell you that what is surface wave? Surface wave is ground wave propagation. As surface wave passes through the ground, you know, as the surface wave passes over the ground, this wave induces a voltage onto the earth surface. And in order to reduce the attenuation effects, okay, the amount of induced voltage, this amount of induced voltage should be removed or should be reduced, okay, so that we can have a reliable communication. See, I'm again repeating the statement, like, this is the way, as the surface wave is the ground wave propagation and its frequency range is limited to 2 megahertz. Okay, so whenever the surface wave passes through any ground surface, so it induces in voltage near to the earth surface. And this induced voltage has some attenuating effects. In order to reduce the attenuation caused by this induced voltage by the surface wave onto the ground of earth surface, the vertically polarized waves mainly reduce the effect of the induced voltages. That will reduce the extent to which the electric field must be in contact with the earth. Do you know that? These vertically polarized waves will tend to reduce the extent to which electric field must be in contact with the earth's surface. Electric field must be in contact with earth surface. In order to reduce the extent by these vertically polarized waves, so that the electric field must be in lesser contact with the earth surface. This I have already told you. Okay. So duct propagation is what? Duct propagation means allows the transmission of UHF and VHF waves. Allows the transmission of UHF and VHF electromagnetic waves through the region near
ट्रोपोस्फेरिक लेयर ऑफ एटमोसफेयर. ओके दैट मीन्स दिस डस्ट प्रोपेगेशन अलाउज द प्रोपेगेशन ऑफ सिग्नल्स बियॉन्ड द होराइजन. बियॉन्ड होराइजन, होराइजन इन होराइजन मीन्स द रीजन वेयर द अर्थ एंड सन टेंड्स टू मीट. ओके सर्फेस वेव, आई हैव टोल्ड यू सर्फेस वेव इंड्यूसेस अ वोल्टेज दैट माइट कॉज सम एटेन्यूएशन. इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द इंड्यूस्ड वोल्टेज ऑन टू द ग्राउंड, वर्टिकली पोलराइज वेव्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर reducing the effect of this induced voltage in order to reduce the extent to which electric field must be in contact with the earth. And duct propagation makes possible the flow of UHF and VHF signals beyond horizon. And what is this super refraction? Super refraction means whenever the atmospheric conditions cause the radar beam to bend more, where there is a more bending of the radio waves than the standard atmosphere. This happens when the atmosphere is stable. When there is a stable atmosphere, okay, relation relative to standard atmosphere, and it results in extension of operational range so that this operational range may extend. Okay, now this sky wave is related to critical frequency. Why? What is this critical frequency? I have told you that the critical frequency is the frequency above which there occurs the penetration. There occurs the penetration in the ionosphere of waves, and below which there occurs the reflection of waves back from ionosphere. Reflection of waves back from ionosphere. Okay, so this is the right state. Next one is fifth question. For reliable, reliable means vishwasniya. For reliable beyond the horizon microwave communication without using repeaters, the frequency of choice would be, see, the answer will be 30 megahertz. 30 megahertz. Since Earth's curvature, this is the Earth curvature, it limits the line of sight communication. It limits the line of sight communication for reliable long distance communication without using repeaters. You know, and ionospheric propagation is used. This is sky wave propagation. That is, it means it is ionospheric propagation for beyond the horizon microwave communication. There is ionospheric propagation, and it is related to 3000 kilohertz, or you can say it is 3 to 30 megahertz. So answer will be B. Next question is, ionosphere propagation is not possible for microwaves. You know, ionosphere, I have already told you that it is responsible for reflecting the radio waves back to the earth surface. Okay, back to the earth surface. So it is not possible for microwaves because what are the options? Just read that microwaves will be fully absorbed by the ionospheric layers. No, there will be an abrupt scattering in all the directions. No, microwaves will penetrate through the ionosphere layers. Yes, and there will be dispersion of microwave energy. No, see what happens, that the frequencies greater than 30 megahertz only will pass through the ionosphere. And you know, microwave frequencies is what? It is around 30 gigahertz. No, so if there is ionospheric propagation whose frequency range is 3 to 30 megahertz, and this is not possible for microwaves because these microwaves, high frequency radio waves, it will penetrate through the ionospheric layers. Okay, so it is not possible. The frequencies, only the frequencies greater than 30 megahertz will pass through ionosphere, and the rest will just penetrate. Okay, so this is the right answer. Next question is, which one of the following is caused by reflection from a stratified atmosphere or from the surface or land conditions along the path? See, the answer is multipath fading. The answer is selective fading, DO fading, or reflection fading. See, fading is what? The reduction of the signal strength. The quality of the signal that gets degraded, the fluctuation of the signal strength. Whenever the signal passes through various destinations in various time intervals, it has different phases, different path lengths. So there occurs the fading effects. That means the quality of the signal gets weakened. So which one of the following is the right option? That is caused by reflection from stratified atmosphere, or stratified means ozone, stratosphere basically. That is, or surface or land conditions along the path. So it will be related to multipath fading. It is the multipath fading effect. The rest is of no use. DO fading, selective fading, reflection fading, no. Next is, In microwave communication links, when fading due to rain attenuation occurs, the techniques adopted for solving the problem would be, see, diversities, you know, diversity that I have already told you, the diversity scheme refers to improving the reliability of the message signal. So only the path diversity and the frequency diversity systems are adopted for fading due to rain attenuation. You know, diversity schemes are mainly useful for improving the reliability of message signal. Okay, so antenna replacement and feed correction, no, it is also not the choice. Amplitude trimming and phase correction, no. Polarization shifting and code diversity, no. When it is related to fading due to rain attenuation, the techniques in order to adopt the for solving this rain attenuation problem is mainly done by path diversity and frequency diversity, because frequency diversity is what? That it is the process of receiving a radio signal on multipath channels. A radio signal is there, if it is on the receiver side, so this radio wave signal is received by multipath channels. Multipath channel means what? Multipath means many path, and channels means different frequencies. Okay, so if it is the process of receiving a radio signal on multipath channels or different frequencies or over a wide radio frequency range or wide frequency band, in order to reduce the effects of radio signal distortions that occur on one frequency component. So this frequency diversity means to reduce the effects of radio signal distortion, to reduce the effect of radio signal distortion. Distortion means change in the shape of the signal. To reduce the effect of the radio signal distortions that occur on one frequency component. That occur on one frequency component. Okay. If the radio signal is being received by multipath channels. And path diversity means where the signal takes multipath to multiple routes to reach the desired destination. Okay. So there is path diversity scheme applied. Now next question is, in microwave communication, sometimes microwave signals reach large distances by following the Earth's curvature. This phenomena is called what? See, this is called as a tropospheric scatter and ducting scheme. Neither Faraday effect nor anisospheric reflection. Tropospheric scatter and this ducting scheme. See, Earth's curvature, these microwave signals have the ability to reach the longer distances by following the Earth's curvature. You know what is Faraday effect? Ducting, I have already told you that ducting is what? It allows the propagation of the signals beyond horizon through the region near tropospheric layer of atmosphere. If it is, see, ducting makes possible the propagation of UHF, ultra high frequency, and VHF signals, okay, and near tropospheric layer of atmosphere, tropospheric layer of atmosphere, and it allows the signal propagation beyond horizon. Okay, so if the microwave signals reach large distances, then they have to follow this ducting scheme, and ducting is possible by near tropospheric layer. So tropospheric scatter is also one of the scheme that is to be employed here. Okay, and what is this Faraday effect? This Faraday effect means the polarization plane of the radio waves that rotates due to magnetic flux lines. I may write it as, this Faraday effect is what? Faraday effect means it is the polarization plane of radio waves that rotates due to magnetic flux lines, and electrons in ionosphere, because there are electrons, free electrons present in ionosphere, okay, that results in different phase velocities, resulting in different phase velocities for लेफ्ट हैंड सर्कुलरली पोलराइज्ड एंड राइट हैंड सर्कुलरली पोलराइज्ड वेव्स. सो दिस द फैराडे इफेक्ट इज नॉट टेकन इनटू कंसिडरेशन इन दिस डक्टिंग इफेक्ट. इट इज ओनली द पोलराइजेशन प्लेन ऑफ द रेडियो वेव्स दैट गेट्स रोटेटेड ड्यू टू द फ्लो ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लाइन्स एंड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दैट एग्जिस्ट इन द एटमॉस्फेरिक लेयर्स व्हिच कॉज द डिफरेंट फेज वेलोसिटीज फॉर लेफ्ट हैंड सर्कुलरली पोलराइज्ड राइट हैंड सर्कुलरली पोलराइज्ड वेव्स प्रोपेगेशन पॉसिबल. ओके एटमॉस्फेरिक रिफ्लेक्शन नो इट इज नॉट ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. सो दिस इज डक्टिंग. This is now this question is 10th question. In microwave communication links, the raindrop attenuation experienced is mainly due to. See, this is the question that you have to consider. Absorption of microwave energy by water vapor, resonance absorption of atomic vibration in water molecules, no. Scattering of microwaves by collections for water drops, no. Refraction means the bending of light or the bending of the radio signal from mode one medium to another medium. No, it is also not possible through liquid drop lenses. Whenever we talk about raindrop attenuation, so it is experienced mainly due to absorption of microwave energy by water vapor, because water vapor has the tendency, that ability that they get, they absorb the microwave energy. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel and please isko like share and subscribe karna mat bhuliyega and please tell me the definition of tropospheric scatter. Okay, write down in comment section. Thank you.